Welcome to part one of the EDIUS X preview. I'm Michael Lehmann-Horn from EDIUS.NET, and with me is EDIUS product manager Alex Kataoka, located in Kobe, Japan. Because of these crazy times, he's with us via internet. Alex, Crespelli has just announced to release EDIUS X on September 15th, so you were able to continue to work on EDIUS X, also the times are challenging.
Hi, Michael. Like with most companies, we were able to have our teams work from home. So we are right on track for the release of EDIUS X in September.
Alex, that's great to hear. We plan to use the time until the release in September to have a monthly preview on EDIUS X. So mid-June, mid-July, mid-August. Today, we'll focus on the core of EDIUS X. Alex, what new features does the new core offer?
Well, it's not about a specific feature, but the real difference will be in the new modular software design. So now the render engine will work completely as a background process now, and the user will not have to wait for EDIUS. And EDIUS will never ask the user to stop when rendering or exporting a file.
So with the background rendering, the user can render, convert, or export while continuing to work with EDIUS X.
Exactly. And I think this new design and possibilities will be a great benefit for many users.
So background rendering is available for both versions, right? For Pro and Workgroup.
Yes. Both versions will offer the new modular design. And this new modular design will be a backbone for more possibilities in the future, such as network-based rendering.
And are there any new features exclusive for Pro or Workgroup?
In EDIUS X, we will support project resolutions to 6K up to 8K, but this will only be available in the Workgroup version. But the EDIUS Pro users will now get the draft preview mode, which was only available in the Workgroup version before. Otherwise, the differences between Pro and Workgroup will pretty much remain the same.
Thank you, Alex. We will come back to you at the end of the show. So now I'm sure that you would like to see how the new modular design can help you to improve your work with EDIUS X. So we asked the EDIUS.NET podcast video team to take a look. And here is their video about the new background render service.
EDIUS X is designed to unleash your creativity and let you work on, uninterrupted. EDIUS is able to play almost everything in real time. But in a few cases, rendering is needed, for example when you export files. Until now, it wasn't possible to continue editing while EDIUS is rendering. But with EDIUS X, this will change. A new render service is automatically installed with EDIUS X. The render engine itself is not visible and operates in the background. You can watch the render service through the GV Job Monitor in the Tools menu. While jobs are rendered in the background, you are able to continue editing. Toast notifications pop up briefly to inform you if the render service needs your attention. All notifications are saved in the Windows 10 Action Center and can be reviewed later at any time.
As EDIUS X works only on Windows 10, users benefit from a tighter integration and a better performance. This enables also a more efficient rendering and export. But most important, the independent render service allows exporting sequences in the background.
In EDIUS X, you will find a new area, XRE, in the export dialog. This XRE technology stands for External Render Engine. It allows you to render jobs in the background. Before EDIUS X, this XRE technology was only available as an option for EDIUS Workgroup. It needed another PC, a server, which rendered the jobs. In EDIUS X, This function is now integrated into both Pro and Workgroup. There is no need for an additional PC, as the rendering is done in the background on the same PC as EDIUS. But you may still purchase an additional XRE license if you wish to use a separate server for additional render performance in the network. If you have purchased an XRE license, you can choose your external machine as the render server. Otherwise, the rendering will happen in the background on your computer, the local host. You can set priorities for jobs. Jobs with higher priority will be rendered first. If you export more than one file at a time, you can decide which will be rendered first and which will be done later. The rendering jobs registered in the render service are executed according to their priority. You can also use the batch export. Here, you can create a batch export list before starting to output the files. This list can be used continuously. The batch export settings are saved with the project. So it is helpful if you regularly need to export the same areas of a project. For example, every time you update the project, you can reuse the export settings. On the other hand, it is also useful if you want to divide a longer video into individual video clips. You simply set the in and out of the desired clip and type in a file name. The background rendering will continue while you keep working on your project. The rendering status and results can be observed in the GV job monitor.
The background render engine can also be used to convert files. This is a feature which might not be integrated in the first release of EDIUS 10, but will follow as a free update.
Bin file conversions into all kinds of intermedia formats will be possible in EDIUS 10. Those conversions of a single file as well as batch conversions take place in the background. This allows you to convert a large number of files while continuing to work on your project. There are different scenarios where a file conversion makes sense. For example, if you work with RAW files or H.265 based files, converting them to the Grass Valley HQX codec helps to improve the performance on your computer. Or you can bring all footage into the standard file format you usually work with. This is a typical workflow for a TV station which has, for example, XDCAM HD or ProRes as their standard format. When converting, you can not only change the file format or codec, you can even change parameters like resolution, frame rate, aspect ratio, and so on. To start a conversion, right-click on one or multiple files in the bin window and select Convert. Here you have three options: File, File Batch, or Alpha Mat. So you can convert a single file, all selected files, or even create file with alpha information. The details of the output format are set in the export dialog. The created jobs can be watched in the GV job monitor. You can also see the progress of the conversion on the clip thumbnail in the bin. When the job is completed, it changes to an online clip.
If you want to render parts of the timeline or clips on the timeline, the background render engine is also very useful.
If you work on a complex timeline, it might be useful to render parts of it. You can visually identify those parts that will not be able to play back in real time. If you play back the timeline, you will see that the indicator on the ruler control changes from orange to cyan, meaning that the area can be played back in real time. Changing to red indicates that this area cannot be played back in real time. In this case, it is useful to render the section. You can either start a rendering job from the context menu of the ruler controller or from the render menu of the menu bar. In general, there are either loaded, orange and red, or overloaded, only red, areas that can be rendered. You can render these areas either throughout the entire project, a sequence, or between the in and out points on your timeline. When selecting between in and out, you can even render everything, including those parts where rendering is not needed. When the render process is registered as a background job, the indicator will be displayed in pink. It will change to green when the rendering job is done. You can observe the job in the job monitor. If you apply any changes to the part which is being rendered, you will see that the color indicator changes back to orange. At the same time, EDIUS will automatically skip the background rendering job for the changed area. Areas which have not been changed will continue to be rendered. EDIUS is known for its excellent real-time capability. If you use non-real-time third-party plugins, you might want to render anyway. To render individual clips or transitions, you can either start the rendering process by right-clicking on the clip on the timeline, or by choosing Render Selected Clip Transitions from the Render menu in the menu bar. If you apply any changes to the clip which is being rendered, you will see that the color indicator changes back to orange. EDIUS will automatically skip the background rendering job for this clip. The clips remain rendered even if you move them on the timeline.
As you have seen, the background render engine is very versatile, and it also includes the former rendered jobs.
Even in earlier EDIUS versions, waveform cache files and proxy files were rendered in the background. In EDIUS 10, these so-called sidecar files are generated by the new background render engine, just like export, conversions, and render processes. You can create a waveform cache file by opening the clip properties and then choosing Refresh Wave Data. The progress is displayed on the thumbnail in the bin window and can also be observed in the job monitor. Here, you can also toggle the priority up or down. Proxy files are created automatically when starting the proxy mode.
Proxy files are encoded in H.264 for a high picture quality at a small file size. H.265 files would even be smaller, but encoding and decoding is very demanding and therefore slow. That's why this file format is not so good supported and still challenging on many systems. EDIUS 10 now offers a broader GPU hardware support to encode H.265. In addition to QuickSync, also NVIDIA cards, which are compatible, can be used to encode H.265.
In earlier EDIUS versions, you could only export H.265 using QuickSync. With EDIUS 10, encoding of H.265 material is now possible with an NVIDIA graphics card. To encode H.265, you need an NVIDIA GPU starting with GTX 1050 or better, RTX 2060 or better, or an equivalent Quadro GPU. The better the GPU, the faster the export and the background rendering.
So GPU hardware acceleration is also available in the background render engine. Crossvalley plans to add even more GPU acceleration within the EDIUS 10 lifecycle to enable the possibility to use the latest PC technology. In general, EDIUS 10 is using advanced hardware and software resources. Therefore, the system requirements are slightly higher than before. EDIUS 10 requires Windows 10 64-bit and a CPU with AVX2 support. That basically means that a PC system older than 8 years is not compatible to EDIUS 10. The current Grass Valley EDIUS 9 Plus promotion allows you to buy EDIUS 9 now and get EDIUS 10 for free. So anyone with an older system can use EDIUS 9 directly and use EDIUS 10 after a PC upgrade. Thank you, Alex, for sharing so many insights into EDIUS 10. The EDIUS.NET team and the EDIUS community do appreciate this very much, and I'm sure those last 20 minutes were worth the time.
Thank you, Michael. It's a great pleasure working with the EDIUS community, and it'll be a great joy to deliver EDIUS 10 with its new possibilities.
The EDIUS users are very loyal for many convincing reasons. One area where EDIUS users wanted to see more possibilities was audio. So in part 2 of our preview series, we'll take a look into the new audio features of EDIUS 10. Thank you very much, Alex, and see you again in mid-July. And I hope you liked this EDIUS 10 preview. My team and I are happy to receive your comments and questions, and we hope you'll be with us again next time.